to eat.
Judy, I'm sure you wouldn't have eaten anything without finding out if we're safe or not.
I don't know. Perhaps if I felt the way Dr. Smith did, dehydrated and everything, I might have.
No, Judy, you wouldn't have touched it. Well, you've had plenty of training in interplanetary travel like the rest of us. As for Smith, he's a doctor, and he's had much more experience than you have. Now, we're going to do everything we can to find him and help him. But let's not fix the blame on something we have no control over, the drought. Don, let's check that culture.
I wonder why Dr. Smith didn't take the robot with him.
What for?
Company. He'd be awfully lonely out there without his best friend.
He's out there somewhere. Maybe dying. Well, there's nothing we can do about it now, Judy. I wish there were.
I can't forgive myself for being so unkind to him.
Well, I don't like to speak ill of him, but he wasn't always very likable, you know.
Only this morning I let him know how I felt about him, using up our water. I know I hurt his feelings.
Well, that's not important now, dear.
Oh, I wish there were some way of letting him know how sorry I am. I wonder if the robot knows where Dr. Smith is.
Where is Dr. Smith, robot?
Dr. Smith is a reluctant inhabitant of this planet. Dr. Smith wants out. Dr. Smith is most anxious to return to Earth. Dr. Smith is...
What'd you do that for?
That's an old tape he made weeks ago that he forgot to erase.
Dr. Smith and this robot must have had a very good understanding.
I guess so. Dr. Smith was a whiz at getting the robot to do things for him. He even got him to play my guitar once. I know he got the robot to do some bad things once in a while, but they don't seem so bad now as they did then. I wouldn't mind if he came back and tried something bad again, just as long as he came back.
I never thought I'd be saying this. But you know, Mother, I miss him. I really miss him. Well, so do I. I keep looking toward the door of his cabin, expecting him to come marching out with a long list of grievances, storming at us because he thinks we're so incompetent. And then stomping off in a huff because we don't pay any attention to him. You know, I read somewhere once that people like Dr. Smith are called injustice collectors. Most of them are really very nice when they're not collecting. We'll find him.
Cheer up, Debbie. You'll get a drink very soon. Beautiful up there, sky. But you'd look more beautiful if you were all dark with clouds and rain was falling and filling the lakes and rivers and the streams. Not until we find Dr. Smith, though.
My time is short, but this you must know and judge. I have plotted their end as they plotted mine. Only theirs will be more lingering than mine. These are the last mortal words of one who, had he survived, would have transfigured the universe. Signed, Zachary Smith.